Hey guys, it's Andre from the High Performance Academy, and we're here with Joe Signorelli from RotorMaster and Gas Motorsport, and we just wanted to take some time to talk to Joe about tuning and how he goes about it. Now, Joe, you're a pretty well-known guy. You've obviously got the record for your Celica for Sport Compact in Australia, and you've also taken the move with this brand new Mustang that we'll have a look at shortly. I just wanted to talk about the equipment you've got here at RotorMaster and Gas Motorsport for tuning. I noticed you've got a Dyno Dynamics four-wheel drive dyno, and then at Gas Motorsport, you've got the Superflow engine dyno. What's your pick of why you use one dyno over the other?
Well, the Dyno Dynamic, we use the chassis dyno, so it's more of a practical dyno. You can put all the street cars on there, four-wheel drive, so all the WRXs and the GDRs can be dynoed as four-wheel drive. But we use it a lot in tuning and installing ECUs. We install the Haltech ECUs and little mods we do. We constantly use the Dyno Dynamic, which is, that still handles up to, we've made 1400 horsepower on this dyno. So it still can handle a bit of power. And like I said, it's a practical dyno, and you just reverse the car on there and dyno it, and away you go.
So it's pretty quick to get a car set up and actually ready to tune. When you say you've got 1400 horsepower through this dyno, it sounds to me like wheel spin isn't as much of a problem as we might expect. How do you cope with wheel spin on a rolling road?
Well, that's the problem with it. You can only, get so much because you've got steel rollers, and we try and tie it down and try different ways of trying to get the tire to stick to the roller. But, there's a method now, the way we strap them down, that does, get to a point where, we make up to that 1,000. We've gone to 1,400, but you still kind of smoke on the tyre, so you don't really, up to 1,000 plus, you don't really know what you've got.
So with all of the high power cars that you're tuning, how much of the tuning are you relying solely on the dyno for, and how much are you doing at the racetrack?
Well, honestly, probably 90% on the dyno. You have to get it pretty much perfect on the dyno, and you kind of just touch up the dyno. Usually, what we do is we kind of run them a bit fatter top end, and then we clear them up at the track.
Okay, so with the Superflow engine dyno that you've got next door, tell us a little bit about that. How much power can that cope with?
Okay, well, the Superflow dyno, that's a 2,000 horsepower plus dyno. I actually dyned my Celica engine in there. That's how we started off. And a few boat engines we've done, a few boat engines, which you can't really dyno a boat engine on the water. So, we get them about, 90% and, fry them in the vehicle and they're fine.
Set up time on an engine dyno, how long does it take you between getting the engine into your workshop and being able to ready to actually do some runs?
That's a problem. I wish it was as easy as this thing. It honestly takes a whole day to set them up, and it's sometimes it's like a three-day process. It's a day and a day tuning, the day to take it off. So it's a three-day process.
So Joe, you've got both the Dyno Dynamics four-wheel drive dyno and you've got your Superflow engine dyno. Tell us a little bit about the accuracy differences between the two.
I think they're pretty well accurate. Between the chassis and the roller dyno, like I said, anything probably even around the 800 down is pretty accurate on the chassis dyno, because you can get the proper traction. But from 8 to 1,000 onwards, the chassis dyno would be a bit hesitant in giving you the true power. Sure. So running the Superflow from 1,000 onwards, you get the precise power.
Okay. The last thing I wanted to ask you, you're well known, obviously, now for your Celica, but you've got a reputation with rotaries. They're a fragile engine, and you seem to be able to hold them together better than most and make them go down the track fast. Have you got a special tuning philosophy that you apply when you're tuning these rotary engines?
Yeah, it goes with all the race cars. When you're tuning them, you're just going to have to, just take back of what you've learnt in the past and... and just apply it to the car and make sure that you don't go too radical with the tune, make sure it's a safe tune to get the car down there, because a lot of rotaries like to run it super rich, and the timing's a big factor in them too, so you've got to make sure that you've got a good good range of timing in it, but that's pretty much like all the cars, all the race cars you do. You're just going to have to, when you tune them, when I tune them and they go to the track, there's something else I do to them. so we can actually go to the track and say, okay, that's a safe tune, and at the track I can just lean on them a bit more.
Okay. Look, we don't want to take up too much of your time. We know you need to get back on that dyno, so thank you for taking the time to talk to us, and we'll let you get back to it.
No worries. Thank you.
For online tuning courses, visit learntotune.com.